medicine drips away. Days burn disintegrate. Years roll along and fade. Don't let them slip away. Right here, right now, today. These are the good old days. Right here, right now, today. Hey, these are the good old days.
In 1982, when kids all around North America were falling in love and playing with G.I. Joe with the real American hero, across the pond in Europe, kids were playing with Action Force, another line of 3¾-inch military action figures. Now, both G.I. Joe, the real American hero, and Action Force are kind of cousins of the 12-inch G.I. Joe or 12-inch Action Man, depending on which continent you were on. Now, growing up in North America, I had no idea that Action Force even existed. The world was so big then, we didn't really have any idea what kids were playing with around the world. We just all assumed it was the same toys we had. Well, over the last few years, I've learned that was not the case, and I've been kind of tiptoeing around the Action Force line. Well, because of some good friends I've made along the way, I've got a handful of Action Force figures here, so we're gonna deep dive and see what we can learn and repair about Action Force in the next few videos. So today, we're going to look at three figures from the first wave of Action Force toys and see if we can't get them back on the shelf.
Come to review your Action Force, Commander.
Yes, yes, I have.
How many will Sir be requiring for his mission?
Well, I am short of one British Marine.
Will he be needing transport? Or will you base him at HQ? Good luck, sir. I expect we'll be seeing you again.
Yes, and take charge of the rest of them until I return, Sergeant!
Yes, sir!
Action Man presents new Action Force minifigures.
Alright, so the Action Force figures we're looking at today are the helicopter pilot, the British Marine, and the mail-away commander. Now we're going to start by looking at the Action Force helicopter pilot. The Action Force helicopter pilot came with four accessories. Well, three if you count the elastic to keep his life jacket on. But he had a life jacket, a handgun, and a machete, which all helicopter pilots need. So we're going to start here and see if we can't make up a replacement for his life jacket. Now I'm learning that these Action Force figures are actually pretty rugged. So this helicopter pilot's in pretty great shape. So once we get his life jacket printed up here, we're simply gonna pour some hot boiling water into this bowl and then put the life jacket in. And then we should be able to form it right around him and he will start looking pretty fantastic. Alright, I think that looks pretty fantastic. I'm really happy with the way that turned out. And with the way that we made it today, we don't need that elastic that originally came with to hold it on. Now the next thing we're going to make is his blue pistol here. Let's go to our 3D space and see if we can't make one up.
All right, and so we've made up this handgun here. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. We're going to print it off, and we're going to print it in blue, because the original handgun was blue. And yeah, I think that looks really, really great. We're just going to give it to our helicopter pilot here, and he's almost done. The last thing we have to make for him is his standard issue machete. And we'll get that made up, and we'll be off to the races. Going to give our machete here to our helicopter pilot so that he can use it while he's flying the helicopter. I'm not too sure how, but I know he can. Looks great. Now moving on to our next figure, we're going to do with the British Marine here. And now he has two accessories as well. He's got a shovel and he's got a self-loading rifle here. So we're going to head again to our space and see if we can't make him up these accessories. And there we have our shovel all set to go, and if we've done our job properly, it should fit right into his hands, so this British Marine can dig a latrine or a grave, whatever is necessary. Look at that, fits great, looks great, and yeah, I'm happy with the way that turned out. Now for the next build, we need to do his self-loading rifle, and so I've imported a picture of it here just to get the proportions right. So I'm going to kind of slice it down and then build up around this silhouette of the gun. And there we have the self-loading rifle. I think it looks pretty good. We'll get it printed up and we'll just give it to this British Marine here and he can start defending the Commonwealth. Yeah, I think that looks really great. I'm really happy with the way that turned out. Now the last figure we're going to look at is the Action Force Mail-Away Commander. Now the Commander was a basic figure that only came with the handgun, the same handgun we gave to the helicopter pilot. So we're just going to simply print off another one of those and give it to him. And very easily, he goes from just being a loosey bin guy to being kind of complete with the repro gun. And I really like the way these guns turned out, so that's very, very good. But I wanted to do something a little special for these guys as being my first Action Force figures we're looking at. So I'm going to make them up some stands and try and make it look like, just like the Action Force logo. So let's see if we can get that done. Alright, I'm going to print these off in a two-color print, and what you get here is some pretty cool-looking Action Force stands. I think they came out really nice. Those colors still just really, really pop. And these figures fit in nice and snug, and they are all set for the shelf. So there you go. There's our restoration on these three Action Force 3¾-inch figures. These are a lot of fun. It feels almost like I'm experiencing toys from a parallel timeline from when I was a youngster. So if you like what we did today, if you had as much fun as we did, like, share, subscribe. If you really want to, you can support us on Patreon. But hopefully, mostly, we want to see you back here for the next video.